The current vandalism cases of electric poles, wires and other electric materials across the country have brought about incontinence and power blackouts in the country. The situation has prompted government to amend laws with tough penalties against the culprits. In a sensitization meeting with security officers in Busoga sub-region at Hotel Continental in Iganga Municipality, organized by Uganda Electricity Authority, ERA, the officers were ordered to charge culprits under the new law. Ibrahim Kasita, Senior Stakeholder Engagement Officer at ERA, highlighted on the law which emphasizes imprisonment of 12 years and paying a fine of 12 billion.
Appraise them and raise awareness on the provisions of the new Electricity Act, the Electricity Amendment Act 2022, which has provisions that, these provisions, for example, if anyone is found, if anyone cuts, damages, destroys the infrastructure, liable to 12 years imprisonment, but also will have to pay a fine between 1 billion to 12 billion to 10 billion. So we are making vandalism of electrical infrastructure so expensive that no one would like to venture.
As for offenders who cut, destroy, transfer, store, and so forth, so it is our understanding with the DPP that these guys who cut be charged with terrorism because their acts are so grievous in nature.
Stephen Okrot called on security officers to join the fight against. He noted that vandalism exposes a danger to lives.
They are using it to make chips. But this oil has other metals which are a health hazard. They have even a little bit of mercury in them. And we are eating. Maybe that's why we are now we are getting obscene and fat, because we are eating some of these oils. We are having cancers, we are having all sorts of ulcers and complications.
Meanwhile, Susan Naluoga, communications officer with the Ministry of Energy, cautioned scrap users and dealers who will be found in possession of any electric materials.
We have a feeling that whatever is vandalized is taken by these metal dealers, scrap dealers, to other markets around dealers. Because right now they are moving freely. They have free market, no one is actually touching them because there isn't any law which is barring them from whatever they are doing. So trade is coming up with a law to help us also fight this problem.
Leaders ask the body to improve on the efficiency of their operations.
You think about people vandalizing them, but leave them there and then they are vandalized by the termites. Even before connection, the wires to the users. So the delay to connect people, it is also another challenge.
Dinner, swamp, and so on and so forth. Removing wires, and then you take them, and you charge everybody. In fact, at one time in Kampala, my wife personally was arrested because they were saying that meter up was weak and it was not supposed to be in that particular area. Later on, when I followed up at police, they told me, no.
The Iganga District RDC, Eddie Mwanje, asked all stakeholders to work together towards the implantation of the law.
Don't blame us. You also look at blaming authority. This has not helped us. This we have information, vandalization, and so on and so forth. Keep us informed such that we put our efforts together and we get rid of such circumstances.
The ERA officials later gave out documents and various brands to popularize the new law.
Also another information poster that you will be able to pin out so that people can know how they can get it.
Story compiled by Ivan Wachibi for the news.